For 15 years. Live from the Five Eyewitness News Studios, it's your happy hour and a half, Twin Cities Live.
Woo! Welcome in, Twin Cities Live. What's going on?
Happy holidays,
happy
everyone.
Happy holidays. It's Wednesday, and we're kind of goofy today. Look, you guys, it's Kelly Hansen.
What do you mean we're goofy? I don't get it.
A little silly. Yeah, what do you mean? What are you talking about?
Your outfit's not weird.
Not at all.
My outfit's not weird.
We decided to just embrace the spirit today and start our Christmas vacation
there
early.
There it
is. It's windy in here.
It is.
Hold on to your scarf, everyone.
I do have to thank you. I will put it out there. Look, we like to be honest and transparent on this show. I went to go look for an ugly sweater in our house, and apparently we had gotten rid of them maybe last year or the year before, so I immediately texted Kelly. I'm like, I don't have a sweater. I'm like, do you have one? Does Steve have one? She found one. So this is hers.
We have the sweaters, and these are not ugly sweaters. They're Christmas sweaters.
That's true. These aren't ugly.
No. I don't think they're fun and festive.
I think they're festive. I think if you showed up to a holiday party or Christmas party wearing this, you wouldn't look like you're like doing a bit. You know, it's not like
right.
You'd walk in
maybe
like,
yours.
Oh, look at the guy with the crazy ugly sweater.
I have a reindeer coming out of my shirt today. Isn't that fun?
It is fun.
Hello, everyone.
Do you have a name? You have a name for said reindeer?
Haven't even thought about it. All right, we'll just let him hang there. We've got a lot of fun things happening on the show today.
We really do. You know, Ashley Wolf is here from the Beef Council. She has three dishes that are perfect for the holiday season, so it's going to be kind of a three-for-one, so to speak.
I like it, including leftovers, what you can do with them for breakfast, which I love. And TCL's favorite therapist, Dr. Karen Ryan, is here to talk about our nervous systems and how we can kind of calm things down over the holidays.
Yeah, we're going to medically geek out.
A few tangible things you can do with your body and your brain and your breath to help you through the holiday season because it is stressful out there.
Yeah, you guys get out your stethoscope and sit back and take some notes because we're going to learn a lot about the human body today.
I can't wait.
We're going to learn some of the reasons why things happen, right?
I love it.
I like it too. Also, Alice Soifert teaches Elizabeth how to make homemade candy bars in today's edition of 12 Days of Cookies. And of course, we're going to pair it with Bridgman's ice cream at the end.
Yummy.
All right, here we go, you guys. It is time. Kelly, are you ready? It's Tricio trivia time. Roll it, everybody. There it is. It's the best jingle in all of TV. So we've played for 13 days so far, and tomorrow, sad, 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 is our last day. Everything under our tree is from Shields, our good friends at Shields, inside the Eden Prairie Center. And every prize is worth at least $150.
Okay, so we have given away a $150 gift card, a Vikings fan package, a Yeti package yesterday. We still have some very fun presents left under the tree, like a family game night package or a hunting package.
All right, so we have a caller on the line. This is Sue Lemire from Richfield.
Hi, Sue.
Hi, Sue.
Hi, guys.
Are you there?
Hi.
How's it going?
Here. Can you hear me?
We can hear you just fine. Can you hear us?
I sure can.
Are you excited, Sue? Are you ready?
I'm extremely excited. In fact, I wish I had that calming person that could have talked to me today to calm me down because I'm so excited about being here.
Well, hopefully, if you win, she'll be able to calm you down later because your nervous system will be so rattled because you've won. I have to ask, Sue, did you watch the show yesterday?
I did. I've got my notes. Hopefully, I wrote them down right.
I love it. It's like Betsy watching The Bachelor or Bachelorette. She's got all sorts of notes. I know all you guys
notes.
Are at home taking all of your notes. So I'm just, as Kelly reads the question, here's my little hot tip. You know, it's not going to be professional, but I do want you to take a few cleansing breaths just to calm yourself down. Center yourself. Close your eyes.
In through the nose, out through the mouth,
that's
too.
Right.
Okay,
right,
Sue, here we go. I read a question. Yesterday, I gave an update on a good company that I initially featured in 2021. Yeah. It was a gas station that transforms into a Christmas boutique during the holidays. What
it's
city?
Vermilion Pump and Market.
There you go.
You did it, lady.
There
I
you
didn't
go.
Get to finish. The question was, what city is it in? And you knew.
Vermilion, and it's a pump market.
You nailed it. You nailed it. I wish I could give you bonus points for getting the actual business name correct. We were just looking for the city, but that's okay.
I love it. Okay.
All right, you ready, Kelly?
The honors?
Oh, this is one of the good ones.
You want to do it or
you
want to
do it? Go ahead. No, you can do it.
Sue, I hope you have a hunter in your life because you have won the hunting package. This
wow.
is a very, very fun gift. You get a pair of Crossfire binoculars and the case, which you don't even have to use those for hunting if you don't want to. And
I
a shield.
I could use those for staring across the street.
That's through your neighbor's windows.
Look, Sue, you don't say that on air, live on TV for all of your neighbors to hear. You keep that inside.
This is a peeping Tom package. A peeping Sue package.
If they recognize my name, they know me. They know. So.
Her neighbors are like looking through their windows. You're also going to get a Shields Outfitters hat. The value was $169.98.
Fantastic.
Congratulations. Happy holidays.
Thank you.
We're so glad you
that
won.
That is so wonderful. Thank
yes.
you so much.
Oh,
good job,
so
Sue. Sue, last question. Are you ready for the holidays? Are you ready to go for Christmas? Everything's set?
Already. Wow. Already. I just got to say, my husband and I, we watch you guys every day, and we just love you all. Thank you so
Sue,
much for your
thank
show.
Thank you. What's your husband's name?
Bruce.
Hi, Bruce.
Hey, Bruce.
Happy holidays. We're so glad you're watching.
He's waving.
All right. Sue, congrats and happy holidays. We appreciate you,
thank you
watching
so
the
much.
Show. Okay, we'll see you later.
All right. Take
thank
care.
You.
Bye-bye.
Nice.
I can't believe Sue just admitted that on TV.
She's looking. I mean,
she
really,
immediately
you,
goes, oh, binoculars for like spying on my neighbors
like
across the street.
When you win binoculars, there's a lot of things you can do with them. That's all, not only hunting.
It's a hunting package. You should use those
sure.
for the things you're going to hunt, not for spying on your neighbors. But enjoy it. I'm sure it's going to be super exciting. And now everybody across the street just went,
I know. That's good stuff.
All right. So tomorrow is our very last Tree CL for this year, and you could be our last contestant. You have to sign up by 10 a.m. tomorrow morning to be considered for entering. It is super easy to enter. Just head over to TwinCitiesLive.com and click on Contest to sign up. Make sure you pay close attention to today's show because we are going to ask you one of those questions. I want you to take all those notes on the graph mm-hmm. paper, just like Betsy does. Big thanks to Shields at the Eden Prairie Center for delivering all of our prizes under a tree once again this year.
You know, they were saying that they watch every day. I just want to say hello to a new friend that I made this morning at the orthodontist office.
Wow, great place
He and his wife
friends.
Watches every day. Kevin, I said, I'd pull my ear. Kevin, this is my hello to you. He said, can you like pull your ear? I said, sure. Here you go. Now I've just said your name. Happy holidays. It was nice chatting with you this morning.
How old is he? Did he have a monocle?
No.
Did not. You just pull your,
you know,
just pull your ear. Just
it
like
was,
this, like on
it
TV.
It was wonderful
oh,
because
that, huh?
he is a grandparent and he was taking his two grandsons to the orthodontist this morning. And I said, that is like the nicest thing you could do for your son to help him out this holiday season. It's a busy time.
It's a busy time.
Yeah.
Making friends.
Kevin did not have a monocle. I think he might have had glasses, though. Anyway, nice to see you, Kevin. Nice
yeah.
to meet you.
Good. Yeah, good shout out. All right, you guys, we both decided to wear ugly sweaters today. They're not ugly. They're perfectly fine. They're festive,
great.
Okay? Just to get you guys in the holiday spirit, they are a little hot. They do not breathe.
No.
We also scoured the internet for the funniest ugly sweaters we could find. We found these on Bored Panda, which is one of our go-to sites mm-hmm. for all these resources. Mm-hmm. So let's start with this one. This one will have you singing, Have Yourself a Hairy Little Christmas.
A Hairy Little Christmas.
There you
it
go.
It looks like he's cut out the shape of a tree, so his chest hair is exposed. Is that what I'm seeing
I
here?
I think that's what you're seeing.
Okay, that...
That's actually really creative.
It's very... That, you know, he could have even made that tree a little bigger.
I think what you could do if you're going to modify this, you move that tree down to your belly button and paint your belly button like an ornament.
Absolutely not. Let's
not.
Go to the next one. This one has your arms becoming Rudolph's antlers... But they kind of look like potatoes sticking out of his arms.
They look like little baby arms hanging off your arms.
At first, I didn't think he had pants on.
What, you didn't think he had pants on?
Did we vet this picture? We do have a team of people vetting things. He does indeed have pants
yeah,
on.
Yeah, he does have pants on,
okay.
and mm-hmm. those apparently are antlers. This one, you turn yourself literally into a reindeer
I like this
yourself.
One.
That's a good one.
You have
one.
To make that face. This one's inspired by the classic Christmas movie, Home Alone.
There's a lot
oh,
going
look.
On there.
You can see he's got his hands. I wonder if somebody stitched that on there. Wow.
Well, that's very much DIY, right?
That's very impressive.
How about this one? This one seems to go on forever.
I like that.
Okay, I can't do that. After a few glasses of eggnog, that one's really going to be trippy.
Yeah, you're going to be really loopy with that one. This one would show what it looks like if a T-Rex tried to put a sweater on with his short little arms.
Okay, that one makes me giggle.
Would hang over his little paws.
I like that one. That one right there is my favorite.
That's a good one.
This one shows what happens when a reindeer has a bit too much Christmas. Mm-hmm. Yeah, puking reindeer. I don't know. Maybe the kids will like that one.
This one was made by a pregnant woman to make her belly look like a festive snow globe.
It's kind of what I was going for with that first one.
Wow, that is so cool.
But think about this, though. I mean, pregnant women, when they're really pregnant, they kind of like always joke around like they got to like walk sideways to the door or something.
They don't joke around.
Oh, so big. Well, in this case, if you really are pregnant and then you add a snow globe onto it, you're not going to get around. You're going to bump into everything.
How is that even I don't understand,
but I love
it.
You're like a bull in a china shop.
Okay, this sweater is made up of tons of tiny other ugly Christmas sweaters. I like that one.
And finally, a sweater that plays a trick on anyone that looks at it.
Oh, it's a mirror.
Mirror.
That's a good one.
That's pretty good, you guys.
Can find an ugly Christmas sweater and just wear it with pride and just embrace it. I love it. Hey, before we get to our commercial break, I want to mention last night I took Quinn to her very first, like, true theater experience at the Orpheum. We went and saw Mrs. Doubtfire. It was such a good show. Dare I say, I don't know if people will agree with me on this, I kind of like the musical better than the movie.
Really?
It was so good. The original music was incredible. The actor that played Mrs. Doubtfire in the movie, his name obviously is Daniel. That's the character's name. He is incredible. And look, I mean, the mask, the way that he changes from Daniel to Mrs. Doubtfire, it's very like peek behind the curtain. It is so fun. And if you get a chance this holiday season, go check it out. It runs through December 24th there at the Orpheum Theater in Minneapolis. And
I can see why you'd say that, because I think in a theater performance you can be much more over the top.
Oh, it was
than you can in the movie.
I looked over at Quinn and she was like laughing at one point, and I got like really like, oh, this is a moment. Maybe she'll remember, because it was her first true, like, you know, adult theater, like with, you know, a traveling group. It was just so cool. It was fun.
Well, maybe in 20 years, she's going to remember when she's doing her own Broadway play. And she's like, I remember going to
Wouldn't
Mrs. Doubtfire with my mom in 2023. Oh, that'd be so sweet. All right.